never thirst again, if we drink the water. You know, we have water inside, but we should drink the water. We have to keep drinking. When we drink, then we will never thirst again. Because in thirst, like, we should not be thirst for people, love, or, you know, like, we should not look something from people to satisfy us. When it happens, if we are not satisfied, then we end up looking from other sources, right? So it means we are not drinking. We are not drinking that water which God put in us. If we drinking, then we will never be thirst. Like, you know, why we should look to others for something? We are not drinking enough. So that's what God is telling. We should receive that love from God. We have to keep receiving love and care, and whatever we needed, we should receive from God. You know, when we are receiving from God, then we don't look outside. And we are satisfied.
Amen.
You know, and we don't need somebody to tell us we are good. Because when we hear God telling you who you are, you don't need others' approval anymore. Right? So you are fully satisfied in you. So you need to drink that water which God given to you. You know? It's like a beggars. If you see beggar don't have food, right? That's why he looks for expectation of food from others. Why he doesn't have? When we have, we don't look. Right? So fear also, like, when we have love, right, we can give to others too. When we have enough love in us from God, we can give love to others. We can forgive others. We can overlook things, you know. The most of the things why we end up looking mistakes in others, because lack of love. You know, because when we love people, we don't look their mistakes. Because love makes us like that. Love gives us such a compassion. If someone is doing wrong, we feel compassion. Instead of getting angry, we actually feel compassion. We really want to help them out. We want to pray for them, we want to be gentle with them, you know, we have such a good understanding about them. Like, you know, it's like our children, right? When we always look, you know, maybe he's tired, you know, whatever. You know, why we come up with very good excuses? Because we love them. Same thing in our neighbors, in our fellow believers. Even though they do wrong, we always want to find maybe something because of that. This is a very good understanding we get because of the love we have for them. So every sin comes because lack of love. That's why Apostle Paul, he said in Romans, he said, all the law summed up in one law, love one another. When you love, the whole Ten Commandments, like, you know, don't do this, you don't do all that. When you love somebody, you are not jealous, you don't criticize, you don't judge, you don't look to them, you know, when you love a person, right? So even fear also comes because of lack of love. Fear or two, why we become fearful? It's because lack of love. You know, 1 John chapter 4 verse 12. No one has seen God at any time. If we love one another, God abides in us and His love has been perfected in us. When that happens, when we love another, when we love others, God's love been perfected in us. And then verse 17, love has been perfected among us in this, that we may have boldness in the day of judgment, because as He is, so are we in this world. There is no fear in love, but perfect love casts out fear, because fear involves torment, but he who fears has not been made perfect in love. So why fear is coming? It means we have not been made perfect in love. So how can we become perfected in love? It mentioned before, right? I read that when you verse 12, if you love one another, God abides in us and His love has been perfected in us. It means when you love one another, His love been perfected in you. When His love is perfected in you, then there is no fear. So it means if we don't love others also, His love is not been made perfected in us. His love makes you perfect, means perfect in every aspect of your life. He makes you perfect so that you stand before the Lord boldly on the day of the judgment. He makes you perfect in everything. When you start loving others, His love is in you. His love makes you perfect. Okay? So we should love one another means not with words. Loving should be in action. We should is not just hugging, telling, oh, I love you, nicely giving smile, hugging. You should go more. Loving is should be done in something, you know, serve one another, right? Go to them. If they have needs, meet their needs. Go and do something about it. Help them out. If they are down, discouraged, go to them. Encourage them. Give them the word and pray for them. You know. So whatever, if they have a lot of work, share the burden with them. Help them. It's for me too. I also have to do. I should come to you and serve you. I really want to do that. I decided. I want to serve you. You also serve one another. You know, that's how our love. Why I'm telling this is, when we have like this, that kind of love among us, all of us, that is called one accord. In Acts chapter 1, verse 1 and 2, what the word says? Acts chapter 2 verse 1 and 2. It says, when the day of Pentecost had fully come, they were all with one accord in one place, and suddenly there came a sound from heaven as of a rushing mighty wind, and it filled the whole house where they were sitting. And then there appeared to them divided tongues as of fire, and one sat one sat upon each of them, and they were all filled with Holy Spirit. See, why it happened? Because they were all with one accord. They were all together with one accord. There's no divisions. No divisions. One unity. Love between them. My water is there. So we need that unity among us. Thank you. Okay? So when we have love for each other like that, and there is oneness, one accord. When there is one accord, power, mighty power came upon them. I'm telling you, because we need power now. We need to increase in the power of God. You understand? When the ministry increasing, power should be increased. There should be balance. When that's why God gave us this direction today to praise, to do praise and worship. Why? Because if there is unity here, oneness, love for each other, definitely one accord will come. Then God wants to release His mighty power on us on the day of Pentecost, same way. When that mighty power comes, then all everybody's blessings are going to be released. Today, why we need a breakthrough? There's so many stuck. There's so many blessings are stuck. So we need breakthrough in our lives. You understand? We need breakthrough in our lives. People are sick in the church now. Not just sickness, blessings are blocked. Today, my prayer partner was praying for me. She saw me, like many visions she saw. One of the visions she saw is, I'm putting a bucket there for the water to be filled up. So there's a tunnel. Is there water is coming, like in the tunnel, water coming, a lot of water. But in the bucket, small, the stream is falling. Small. Why? Because there's a lot of junk collected. That is blocking the flow of water to come into the bucket. So I'm just asking God what it is. It's like I'm really crying out for power. We need more power to come. But what that power is blocking, there's no oneness, unity. If we have oneness, if we have one accord, we have anything, the garbage in the mind, throw it down, the garbage out. Let's have one accord. Then the water is going to gush. Water will come. The bucket needs to be filled. That's, we need power. More power. Today I ask Sister Leah, give me direction. I'm going to intercessory. Give me direction. What to pray? She prayed and said, she told me that there's a lot of need of prayer is there. She told me that you all guys have to just worship. No direction. Worship. Worship, 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 worship. And make sure everybody filled with the power. Receive power and go. There's nothing else you can do now. Just worship, praise and worship and receive more power. Don't just start breaking things if you don't have power. If you are empty vessels, how can you go against the enemy? We need to be filled with the power. You understand? We have to be received. The power, why the power is blocking? Why it is the like a Pentecostal day? Why that power is not coming on us? We have power a little bit. But this is not enough, because the work what we are doing, the calling what we God given us is a mighty big one. We need more power. This power is not enough. We need more. That the corporate worship. That's why when I'm worshiping here, people are all back, like one here, one there, one. I don't feel I'm worshiping with the family. Let it be like a family. Let's all like a family together, worship together like a family. Why don't you just come move forward? Why can't we see each other? Just one here, one there, one there. I can't see. I'm just thinking like in my home, I'm worshipping alone. What is the, for me, benefit of coming to church if still I'm standing alone worshipping? I can do that in my home too. I want to worship with the family. Come on, just come together, just as a family. Together, let's worship God. Together, let's receive the power. Hallelujah. Let's do that.